Hi, I'm Dr. Jenny Sanders, and today I'm going to be reviewing Saucony Progrid Hurricane 13 and comparing it to Saucony PowerGrid 14. I've had a love-hate relationship with the Hurricane. Some years it's been great, some years not so much. I have to say though that with the 13, I've become a huge fan. This shoe is for the excessive pronator. It's significantly stable and it's one of my all-time favorite shoes. Hurricane 14, not so much. Let's talk about the upper. Hurricane 13 has this wonderful arch lock. It gives you lots of support in the midfoot, hugs you, really gives you a nice ride. Hurricane 14, bloated, sloppy, saggy, not a nice ride. Let's talk about the heel counter. One of the ways that a running shoe is made more structured or stable is with a firm heel counter. There's a plastic inset that goes into the back of the shoe or the heel counter area so that when you hit the ground, instead of pronating excessively with a high rate of speed, if the heel counter is firm, it slows you down. The Hurricane 13 has this in spades. The 14, it's a marshmallow. Now let's talk about the lower. The Hurricane 13, again, it's just a wonderfully structured, stable shoe. Nice, firm EVA in the midsole. Torsionally stable, doesn't twist. Again, really helps with excessive pronation. The 14, torsionally unstable. Very flexible. Finally, the forefoot flexibility. Hurricane 13, nice resistance to forefoot flex. The 14, you can fold it up like a ball. I don't get it. The 13 is a perfect running shoe. It's stable, it accepts an orthotic, it's good for excessive pronators. The 14, it's like a comfortable couch. It feels good, but at the end of the day, you wind up with a back or neck ache. This shoe is not in the same category whatsoever as my beloved Hurricane 13. And for this reason, I not only can't endorse Hurricane 14, I have to toss it out.